In this video, we'll talk about how to split up a poly wave file into individual files. Now, first of all, what's a poly wave file? If you have a fancy recorder or perhaps a cinema camera that can record more than two channels of audio, it will often record that as a poly wave file. And what it will do is it will create a new track within that poly wave file for each microphone or each input. So here, for example, I recorded on my sound device's Mix Pre this file here, and it has four different channels. In fact, we can find that. I'll go to the edit page. I can just take this file, drop it right into my timeline, and you'll notice there are four different tracks. And the nice thing is it split it into four different tracks for us, so we're actually probably done if you're going to be editing here in DaVinci Resolve. Now, if you are not, you can also export just the tracks that you need and create new files for them if you want to do that. Again, if you're going to be maybe bringing this into a different video editing app, nonlinear editor, or a different digital audio workstation, you can do all of that. So I'm just going to make these a little bigger. I'm going to Shift Z to make them fill the majority of the page here. Hold down Shift and scroll on my mouse here, make them a little bigger. Now, what are these four different channels here? In my particular case, it looks like channels one and two are the same thing. And indeed they are, because on my sound device's Mix Pre, it recorded the first two channels is a stereo mix. So it took microphone one and microphone two and recorded both of those to the stereo mix. The first channel is the left speaker and the second channel is the right speaker. I don't actually need those. I actually want to keep them separate because I want to be able to edit them separately. Maybe person one on microphone one was a little louder, or they had a different voice that's substantially different and I wanted to process it separately. We can do all of that. Now, I can do that right here in DaVinci Resolve. And the first thing I need to do though is you'll notice if I click on any of these tracks, it highlights all of them. Well, let's say I want to get rid of the stereo mix. I don't need that. The way I can do that is right click and choose link clips. I want to uncheck link clips. When I do that now, I can select just one track at a time and press delete on the keyboard to get rid of it. That's all I have to do. Now, if I want to get rid of these open channels here, these open tracks, I can right click and choose delete empty tracks and it just gets rid of them. Great. Now, if I was just working in DaVinci Resolve, I could go right ahead and drop a series of effects on this track, others on this track or on this clip, and process them independent of each other, and that would be fantastic. But if I'm not working in DaVinci Resolve, I just want to get these files out into a different application. What I want to do is select these two tracks. So I'll click on this one. I'll then hold down the Shift key on my keyboard and select the next one. Then I'll come over here, right click on this first one and choose Export Audio Files. That brings up this dialog box. And first we want to choose the folder name. I want to choose clip name. I want to auto rename each duplicate so that they each get different names. You don't overwrite each file with a different track. I'm going to save it in BWAV format, broadcast wave format. That's great. Almost any app will read that. I want to choose a sample rate the same as a project, 24-bit, interleaved, and here's an important one. I want to choose export individual clips. I want to do that so that each of these tracks is saved to a separate file. I want to choose the entire timeline, and in this case, I only want to use the selected tracks. If you want to export all of the tracks, you could uncheck this and it'll do that as well, but we only want the selected ones. As one example, the export width, if I haven't done any processing, none of these will matter whether they're checked or not, so I just leave them checked. And in our case, we're not going to do any normalization. That's a different tutorial for another time. I'm going to go ahead and click export, and just to prove it, let's go ahead and drag this in. And you can see that's exactly the same as audio one right here, and this second one here, drag that in, and that is the same as audio two. So it worked beautifully. That is how you take a poly wave file and split it in DaVinci Resolve Fairlight.